Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, welcome. And if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. I do appreciate all of you guys being here. So today I'm going to be sharing with you some of our dividend winners from 2023. So I will, let me zoom in. And while I'm zooming in, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. I'm trying to like do this with one hand and talk, but make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell notification button so that you don't miss an upload every time I post a video, and leave me a comment down below. We are journeying towards 20,000 subscribers. So I cannot get it there without all of you guys. So thank you so much for your support. Not a financial advisor or a fiduciary. I'm just a regular investor trying to get her and her family to financial freedom. So I'm going to be, like I said, sharing with you guys some of our dividend winners for 2023 when it comes to the taxable accounts only. Okay, so you're right here in my spreadsheet. This is something that I keep track of. You guys know I'm a spreadsheet junkie, and I really like to track all of our dividends. Again, if you want to track your dividends along with me, check out my links below in my description box. I created several types of books, digital downloads, and a spreadsheet for those of you who want to track along with me. Put a lot of hard work into them. I think they're reasonably priced, and it's a great way to support the channel and support yourself when it comes to your journey. Okay. So far, this is as of November, year to date November. So I have yet to add up all of the dividends for 2023 because I'm filming this video on Thursday, December 28th. So I want to wait for the year to close out. But like, we reduced our BP. I think we had 75 or 100 shares. We put it back down to about 50 shares because we were like over leveraged in the energy sector. We have ExxonMobil, BP, Wanek, ET. I love energy, but I don't want a whole lot of it because then the portfolio is lopsided. That's the only downside with dollar cost averaging, in my humble opinion, is that you don't see, like, if you're totally leveraged, like, a lot, you know, in one area, even with funds, right? I mean, I like diversification, so I'll have, like, VTI and SCHD and JEPI, which we did receive our share size goal in, so that's why you don't see me talk about it much. But if you watch our dividend income videos or you go back to the previous videos, you'll see more about JEPI. But yeah, so let me come down so that I can show you. So this is why I track everything. So it's important to track your stuff. Track all of your information because it's so important. Before I get to the winners, I just wanted to come here because I wanted to show you guys the little charts that I make. Let me just move my mouse over so that you guys can see it. I may need to zoom out. Let me zoom out a little bit because you can't really see the graphs. You really can't see it there either. Let me go out. Okay. So you can't see this right here, but this is cash, energy, healthcare, consumer staples, financials, and real estate. But another way that I like to track our portfolios is by graphs, not just like the spreadsheet part, which you saw above, but like this helps me to see like, okay, how much money do we have in certain sectors, in certain industries, even with ETFs as well. So with SCHD, I really like SCHD. It's not a lot of tech in it, which I love, but it's not the only ETF that we like. So you can see in our taxable accounts, SCHD is about 17%, which is not bad. JEPI is about 10% again, which is not bad. JEPQ is about 3.4. Realty Income is about 5. You have TSLY, which I really want to sell, at about 5. And you can come over here, you can see like the different sectors as well. So like we have 5.7% in communications, and then move my head. 15% in tech. That's a little bit high for me for the taxable accounts. I love tech, but it is more volatile. I like the fact that our ETFs is about 30% of just our taxable. Now, again, our retirement accounts is mostly ETFs, like 95% of our retirement HSA, 401ks, Roth IRAs are 95-97% ETFs. So we are heavy in ETFs. But when it comes to our taxable accounts and like dividend income, we really like to get this more to, let's say, 40%. So again, now next year I know where to focus a little bit more at. So if we come down some more, these are the sector breakdowns by portfolio. portfolio, or excuse me, by percent. So communications, consumer discretionary, consumer staples, ETFs, that's not a sector, but ETFs, cash is not a sector, but sometimes I'll transfer cash and then I don't invest it right away. So I have a option for cash, energy, tech, real estate, financials, industrials, and healthcare. And then move over some. Let me see. And then total sector allocation. So it should equal 100%. So I'm not sure why that says 0.07. I have to go back and fix an error somewhere in my calculations. But that's an easy fix for me. But you can see, like, for example, down here, the green is what the current allocation is. And up at the top is like ideal. So we're kind of on a mark with the ETFs. Total, you know, SCHD is an ETF, QILD is an ETF, JEPI is an ETF, VTI is an ETF. So, you know, make sure you guys understand that those are not individual stocks. And then let me come down here so that you can see some of our investment winners. Again, I just wanted to give you guys like a detailed walkthrough. So let me come down some. All right, and then I'm going to scroll over some. All right, so you can see right here some of our winners, and this is based off of the information that I showed you above. This is why I'm always tracking everything when I do the videos for the dividend income reports and the portfolio updates. This is why I'm doing that. Excuse me, guys, my throat is a little, I'm trying to fight off a cold. It's trying to get me. It's trying to get me, guys, but I'm fighting back. But these are some of our winners, okay? So these positions are up just in our taxable accounts at least 15%, okay? And some of these are closer to 40%, which is insane. So BP, which I really, really do love, I've been investing in it consistently. Though we were kind of over leveraged in the energy sector, BP has been really good to us. Same with ExxonMobil, which was like at 9%. But again, I'm trying to show 15% up to 40%, because I made a video recently sharing some of the dividend stocks we were down in. We were down, and Realty Income still is. Still is. It's coming back, but still is, right? QILD is barely down. Altria, ticker symbol MO, we're down in that. But we're also up in many of our positions. And so you can see BP up almost 17%. Aflac up almost 38% year to date, which is insane. A great insurance company. This is actually one of our focuses for next year. Wanek up 17.77%. Target up 32%. I wish I would have got more. We do have Target in a retirement, but wish I would have got more. And I'm still going to buy little pieces of it. Seagate. This should be Gate. I spelled this wrong. Let me fix this right here while you guys are with me. Okay. We're just going to keep it real, right? Okay, Seagate, ticker symbol STX, that's up 19%. I wish I would have bought more there as well. I was just so focused on SCHD because we were so close to 500 shares. So yeah, VTI, look at VTI. VTI is now our VTI position just in Interactive Brokers, not anywhere else. Again, this is just taxable accounts, 16.23%, which is amazing. I think overall it's up to about 24%, like in our retirement accounts and everything. But again, I'm just like stoked with this return. And then Google were up 32%, Amazon up 35%, and then we have Apple in our M1 account, the $1 a day investing challenge. I wanted to put this here, up almost 27%. And again, we've been having that as our pick several times during the past 3 years. You guys love Apple. And again, the market always comes back. Yeah, it may look daunting. It's a lot of red everywhere. It's a lot of fear. But look right now. I mean, since what, November? It's been up consistently. So again, guys, buy and hold, and what you believe in, you got to believe in it. No one else. You got to believe in it. Do your research and just dollar cost average. Be consistent. And I'm telling you, it always works. So that's the video today. I wanted to share with you some of our investment winners when it came to our dividend stocks. Just picked a few of them that was up. Now we have many of them that are up like 10%, 8%, 13%, but I just wanted to focus more on 15% and higher. So again, guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Smash the notification bell so that you don't miss an upload every time I post a video. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know one of your investment winners for 2023, like one stock or fund that you were dollar cost averaging in and now you're up 10%, 15%, 20%, even 5%. Let me know, and I love chatting with you guys below. Again, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you need any resources, need any help, dividend books, trackers, spreadsheets, digital downloads, a lot of this, oh, not a lot of it, all of it, I made from scratch out of this brain. I figured, you know, create things that I wish I had when I first started. Maybe it could be of help to someone else. So check out those links down below. If you want to open any investment accounts, all my referral links are down below. It doesn't cost you anything, and it's a great way to support your sister and her channel. Okay, so again, thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll see y'all in the next one, and Happy New Year. Bye-bye.